Please open mind. Discern this and all information. September 14, 2016. A summary of the Rothschild crime syndicate in Israel. Posted on the eventchronicle.com. By Alexander Azajan. There has been so much that has already been written about the Rothschild crime syndicate that for those who aren't part of the Great Awakening / Truth movement, it simply gets confusing and overwhelming. It is my intent to unravel that in this article and to speak to common people and not just the intellectual elite. Before I begin, I want to emphatically state the following: to those Freemasonic architects of control whose aim has always been to lie and confuse the masses by muddying the truth, let it be clear that what I am about to discuss is not a conspiracy theory, a pejorative they commonly use when they crave to assassinate articulate debate. No, we are academics, we are not interested in conspiracy theories. However, we are very much interested in conspiracy facts. And may I remind you of the old Christian saying that the biggest trick the devil has ever pulled throughout human history was to convince the masses that he doesn't exist. With that preface in mind, I now get into the crux of the matter. For approximately 250 years, the multifaceted Zionist Rothschild crime family, with its prototypical Luciferian, anti-Christian, globalist aspirations, has desired to intertwine and morph itself into the global financial power structure as well as the mass brainwashing apparatus that we now call the controlled Western mainstream media. And up to now, they have mainly succeeded. But in the last two decades or so, albeit slowly but surely, things are finally turning against them, thanks primarily to the general global awakening movement facilitated through an unprecedented proliferation of knowledge, courtesy of the information technology revolution. If we aim to truly expose the satanic Illuminati agenda and the New World Order mechanism that has been in making for centuries, then we must arm ourselves with the up to now hidden facts of not just the version of history that has been taught to us in our mainstream, so-called educational systems, but instead turn to the alternative, hidden version of history which used to only be known in various occult circles throughout the world, especially the Western so-called civilization. And it is nearly impossible to delve into such matters without stumbling into the name Rothschild. Yes, information was always power. George Orwell put it best in his legendary book, 1984, "He who controls the past controls the future. He who controls the present controls the past." The Rothschilds are what I call the ultimate, obsessive-compulsive architects of control, so meticulous that there has been few examples in history. Here are some brief and on-the-surface facts about the Rothschilds. In 1917, the British arm of the Rothschilds crime syndicate effectively arm-twisted and forcibly lobbied the British government to promise to grant them Palestine in exchange to getting the United States to get involved in World War I on the side of Britain and thus ensure British victory over Germany, etc. Thus the Balfour Declaration was created. This was a one-page official letter, business executive summary style, from the British Foreign Secretary at the time Arthur James Balfour to Baron Rothschild stating the following: "His Majesty's government views with favour the establishment in Palestine of a national home for the Jewish people, and will use their best endeavours to facilitate the achievement of this objective." There was a big problem with this scenario: Palestine was never Britain's to grant away. It rightfully belonged to the Palestinian Arabs who had dwelt there for centuries, approximately 2,000 years to be exact. In walked in the Rothschild Zionists, usurping their way in as usual since this has been their traditional method for time immemorial. Slowly but surely, they started to brutally and forcefully evacuate the land and take over. In the past several decades, the Zionists have murdered and victimized millions of Palestinians. They are still committing genocide to this day with the full blessing of Washington, of course. According to English historian Simon Schama, the Rothschilds own 80% of what they have opportunistically called Israel, a blasphemy unto itself according to the true Torah Judaism, which correctly believes, according to the Judaic biblical understanding, that after the destruction of the Temple in Jerusalem in 70 AD that a nation of Israel can only be assembled by the Messiah himself and absolutely by no earthly authority. The creation of the Zionist state of Israel was massively unjust right from the beginning, an entity conceived in treachery and justified vis-a-vis the evil of the burnt offering, otherwise known as the Holocaust. This profound inequity continues to breed conflict today, as has been the case all along. It is no exaggeration to state that the founding of this Rothschild Zionist state itself, along with the blind and absolute ideological and financial support by many in Washington, may dangerously be a precursor to World War III, as we are all witnessing this possible trend in the Middle East. It's hard to fathom that this puny Rothschild Zionist-created state, which measures no more than 8,019 square miles, all of it illegal and stolen of course, practically controls the Middle Eastern foreign policy mechanisms of the governments of the US, the UK, Canada, France, and many others. Apparently for now, size doesn't matter. What matters is that the Rothschilds have always been fully behind this Frankenstein golem. In fact, they are the Frankenstein itself. At any rate, here are some facts about the broad spectrum of the power of the Rothschild crime syndicate. The Rothschilds own the Reuters and the Associated Press, AP, the two biggest news media agencies in the world, which naturally have stayed subservient to their master's propaganda talking points. The Rothschilds also have a controlling share in the Royal Dutch Oil Company, the so-called Bank of England, LBMA, London Bullion Market Association, the Federal Reserve, the European Central Bank, ECB, IMF, World Bank, and the Bank of International Settlements. The Rothschilds also have ownership of the majority supply of actual physical gold in the world. They own the London Gold Exchange, which sets the price of gold every day. It is estimated that the Rothschilds own over half of the wealth of the entire planet, estimated by Credit Suisse to be $231 trillion, which is controlled by the 85-year-old Evelyn Rothschild, the current head of this crime family. In 2005, Forbes magazine ranked Mayor Emshel Rothschild, the original godfather of the family back in the 18th and early 19th century, as the number 7 in its list of the 20 most influential businessmen of all time. Incidentally, Mayor Emshel Rothschild is referred to as the founding father of international finance. The Rothschilds were directly involved in financing the British in their War of 1812, when England invaded Washington, D.C. and burned our nation's capital to the ground. 3 years later, in 1815, the Rothschilds took complete control of the Bank of England. The Rothschilds were also directly involved in financing the Southern secessionists during the American Civil War, 1861-1865. President Lincoln's assassin, John Wilkes Booth, was in fact a Rothschild agent. After their hostile takeover of the Bank of England in 1815, the Rothschilds have been expanding their banking control literally all over the world. Their method, pressuring various countries' corrupt politicians to accept massive loans, which they can never repay and thus go into a form of debt slavery to the Rothschild banking powers. If a leader refuses to accept the loan, he is oftentimes either ousted or assassinated. And if that fails, invasions can follow. Does that sound familiar? As stated above, the Rothschilds also exert powerful influence over the world's major mainstream news media. By repetition, the masses are duped into believing horror stories about evil dictators Saddam Hussein of Iraq, Muammar Gaddafi of Libya, and now Bashar Assad of Syria, etc. Again, does that sound familiar? The Rothschild crime syndicate has had their hand in fomenting nearly every European war, two of which were designed to become world wars, during the past 250 years. They also install presidents and prime ministers, install and dethrone kings, with Freemasonic puppet replacements, bankrupt nations through wars and rumors of wars, along with economic tools, their favorite modus operandi, such as interest rate manipulations, contrived economic bubbles followed by financial collapses, recessions, and economic depressions, in addition to currency exchange manipulations, and the list goes on and on. On the indirect, non-economic front, they have always worked hard from behind the scenes, of course, vis-a-vis the hidden hand of the immoral and godless modern Freemasonic movements to corrode long-cherished moral values, spread all manners of sexual perversions, spread moral relativism and ambiguity through the modern, secular educational systems, create and foment social, ethnic, cultural, political, and geopolitical divisions, divisiveness, and sectarianism. From the start, they aimed to destroy Western Christianity, Catholic and Protestant alike, which unfortunately to some extent they have succeeded. But we must be grateful for the resurgence and revival of Eastern Orthodox Christianity as a viable moral, ethical, and political force to be reckoned with, especially among the youth of Russia and Eastern Europe. In this area, they are utterly failing. This is one of the reasons for their fanatical Russiaphobia media campaign. And as for the true, revolutionary, modern Islam, the Rothschild Zionists perceive that as their greatest threat, while all along, they foment and fund the most brutal and savage-like versions of false Islam such as Wahhabism and Salafism via their Saudi and Qatari proxies via ISIS savage mercenaries. This is so since their ultimate geopolitical plan in the greater Middle East region is to first evacuate big chunks of it, vis-a-vis the chaos, lawlessness and the wars that generate the current refugee crisis, as in Syria and Iraq, etc., in order to once and for all implement their so-called Greater Israel project, from the Nile to the Euphrates, in order to directly control and spiritually abuse the powerfully esoteric energies of these very ancient and mystical lands. And their trump card, the so-called Samson option, Israel's deterrence strategy of massive retaliation with nuclear weapons against any country whose military may defensively attack Israel. These are but some exoteric examples of their wicked strategies. Back to some of the geo-economic strategies of the Rothschilds, here comes the Iran dossier. Could gaining control of the Central Bank of Iran, CBI, be one of the main reasons that Iran has been targeted and demonized by the Western media and the warmongers in Washington and Tel Aviv? Objective researchers point out that Iran is one of only three countries left in the world whose central bank is not under Rothschild control. Before 9/11, there were reportedly seven: Afghanistan, Iraq, Sudan, Libya, Cuba, North Korea, and Iran. Not that they would amount to much in the macroeconomic global sense. By 2003, however, Afghanistan and Iraq were completely swallowed up by the Rothschild system, and by 2011 Sudan and Libya followed. In Libya, a Rothschild bank was established in Benghazi while the country was still at war. Again, objective researchers contend that Iran is not being demonized because they are a nuclear threat, as facts have proven over and over that Iran is clearly not a nuclear threat. And yet, the Rothschild-controlled mainstream media relentlessly keeps repeating this lie even after the signing of JCPO, the acronym for the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action between P5+1 and the Islamic Republic of Iran. What then is the real reason? Is it the trillions to be made in oil profits, oil theft, or the trillions to be made in war profits, a centuries-long Rothschild specialty, or is it to start World War III for whatever diabolic financial incentive, or is it to simply destroy the CBI, Central Bank of Iran, so that no one is left to defy Rothschild's money racket? It might be any one of those reasons, or worst, it might be all of them. To sum up, what used to be pejoratively referred to as a conspiracy theory is now being discussed openly among credible academics, cutting-edge independent think tanks, and ultimately the governments of the nations of the world. Lastly, an old John Maynard Keynes and E. F. Schumacher concept for a global currency called the Bancor may still be a global currency idea, and along with it the controversial global central bank. The criminal godfather, Mayor Emshel Rothschild, famously said, "Give me control of a nation's money and I care not who makes her laws. Whoever continues to control the monetary system of the world will in effect control the policies and laws globally speaking." What is the Rothschild strategy in achieving this? One of the preliminary measures of incorporating a global currency seems to be the destruction of all currencies around the globe in order to justify its inception. As stated, calls for a global currency began to come about after World War II, when John Maynard Keynes and the British government proposed the Bancor as a world reserve currency. The current ongoing economic crisis, especially ever since the Great Recession of 2008, has set the stage for the demise of the dollar as the current world reserve currency in order to possibly make way for this proposed Bancor or whatever other name they come up with to make their propaganda more marketable. One thing is for certain, Washington and the Fed are in on the plan, as the Fed continues to devalue the dollar through quantitative easing, better put, printing more and more paper money. Washington continues to grow by spending more and more only to exacerbate the problem. Perhaps, this is all part of the Rothschild plan to destroy the dollar once and for all. Timothy Geithner, former president of the New York branch of Fed as well as Barack Obama's Secretary of Treasury from 2008 to 2012, openly endorsed the one world currency. Some argue that the U.S. housing market bubble, U.S. auto industry's near collapse and the subsequent government bailout, Wall Street and banker bailouts, as well as the drastic reduction in manufacturing here in the U.S. are all contrived events in order to systematically crush the U.S. economy and the dollar, with the intent of making way for phase two of the ominous Rothschild takeover of the world's monetary systems and the completion of a new world order feudalistic dictatorship. The writing is certainly on the wall. Now, let the real people's social, political, economic, and most importantly spiritual revolution begin. We are at the threshold and some would say at the midst of this grand new reality. Thanks for listening and watching. Subscribe and share.